Hello to my subscribers and all who are watching us. In this short video, we will answer some interesting questions. What do knock sensors do? The knock sensor is listening to our engine. The engine's knock sensor detects pre-ignition and detonation, potentially damaging forms of abnormal combustion. Though full-blown knocking and pinging are audible to the human ear, the knock sensor detects imperceptible levels. The knock sensor uses an internal piezoelectric element to detect abnormal combustions inside the engine, called a spark knock. What happens when a knock sensor goes bad? This is because a faulty knock sensor can cause the AQ to adjust the ignition timing incorrectly, resulting in poor combustion and wasted fuel. Engine misfires can also cause other problems, such as increased emissions, reduced fuel economy, and damage to the catalytic converter. Is it okay to drive without a knock sensor? In conclusion, you can drive with a bad knock sensor, but if you begin to feel problems in the way the engine sounds, runs, or performs, scan for codes or have it checked to see if you get knock sensor DTCs. Why do knock sensors fail? Knock sensors can break down for a variety of different reasons relating to installation, maintenance, and performance during use. Issues could be caused by incorrect installation or use of a faulty component, such as a knock sensor with bad wiring. Excessive vibration could have shaken loose a connection, caused damage to the sensor, or could be preventing the sensor from doing its job. Is a knock sensor a big problem? Reduced engine performance. A faulty knock sensor may cause the engine to run poorly, with a lack of power and acceleration. This can happen when the sensor cannot detect an engine knock, causing the engine to run with inefficient ignition timing, decreasing the engine's performance. The five signs and symptoms of a bad knock sensor are: check engine light comes on, engine misfire, engine knocker ping, poor fuel economy, engine damage. How to test a knock sensor? It's a good idea to test a suspect knock sensor before you rush out and buy a new one. Before getting started, however, you'll want to have the vehicle's repair information handy. Step 1. Check for diagnostic trouble errors codes DTCs. The first thing you'll want to do is check for errors that could narrow down the troubleshooting process. Cars built after 1996 with onboard diagnostics OBD2 will usually set a code when there's an issue with the knock sensor or its circuit. Some older cars with OBD1 will also store an errors code when there's a problem with the knock sensor. Faulty parts like bad spark plugs can cause a knock sensor code, so you'll need to inspect your vehicle thoroughly if it sets a DTC. You can check for diagnostic trouble codes using a scan tool or code reader. These days, you can even get an inexpensive OBD2 code reader for your smartphone. It's important to point out, however, that DTCs do not tell you the exact problem with the car. Codes merely serve as a starting point for further diagnostics. Step 2. Perform a visual inspection. Next, you can move on to performing a visual inspection. You'll want to look for issues, such as damaged wires and poor connections. Make sure that the knock sensor's electrical connector is clean and tight. Repair any issues found during the visual inspection, clear the DTCs, and see whether the problem returns. Step 3. Before removing a knock sensor, ensure that the ignition is turned off. Firstly, check the resistance of the sensor using a multimeter. You can do this by connecting it to the sensor's connectors. The resistance should be between 2000 and 3000 ohm. If this is not the case, the sensor is probably faulty. If the correct resistance is present, check the electrical connectors associated to the knock sensor. If no voltage is present, check all wiring to ensure that there is no damage to the circuitry. Step 4. Test the knock sensor directly. Testing a knock sensor can be tricky. There are two primary types of knock sensors: wideband piezoelectric and resonance piezoelectric. In the past, when wideband piezoelectric sensors were more common, a popular test method was to tap on the engine near the knock sensor. If the sensor responded to the vibrations, you knew it was working to some degree. But that test does not work on the newer resonance-style sensors. Most professionals test these sensors using an alternate method, which involves forcing the engine to ping while monitoring the sensor's output signal. Thanks for your attention, and please subscribe our channel.